There's the old adage, I guess, that you can't manage what you don't measure. Businesses and building owners can address their environmental, social and governance responsibilities, and they can do it in a way that reduces emissions, saves on their energy bills and helps them to access the various incentives from the schemes that are available from the government. So with our transition to the renewable energy, we're going to get new reporting requirements that building owners and businesses have to keep up to date with. The CSIRO Data Clearinghouse is a software platform that collects and manages data relating to energy efficiency in a building. It helps building owners to collect and consolidate all the data so that they can use it to satisfy all their reporting requirements, including NABERS ratings. The CSIRO Data Clearinghouse creates an official baseline that can be used to track and demonstrate your emissions reduction in the building. The insight can be used to save money and reduce emissions. So this is all quite new. So building owners now have got the opportunity to look around their building for flexible demand assets to save them emissions and reduce costs. They include batteries, electric vehicles, they include thermal storage like hot water and air conditioning systems. These can all shift their load over the time of the day in order to match consumption with the availability of renewable energy.
Renewable generation fluctuates much more than that of traditional generation methods. Flexible demand assets allow the building owners to consume the energy when it's at low cost periods during the day, store it or use it during high cost.
Ideally, building owners will use their flexible demand assets to shift their usage and take advantage of the storage to consume energy when it is low emissions and lowest cost to them. So we need the flexible demand assets to be digitally connected to take advantage of the low emissions, low cost renewable energy. Businesses and building owners are looking for a platform that is secure, it uses interoperable standards, and it provides ownership of the data for the building owner.
Data sovereignty is a really important part of the data clearinghouse. In this, we want to avoid vendor lock-in and proprietary systems controlling our users' data by providing them access controls and the ability to remove their data whenever they want.
So what the data clearinghouse will be doing is it will be collecting and storing and timestamping all the electricity meter data, and it will be then learning the behaviour of the building and creating a baseline energy consumption profile for the building. When using the flexible demand assets to shift energy consumption, we can calculate the energy that's been shifted and the emissions savings and cost reductions that have been achieved. Our net zero buildings are generally calculated using average annual emissions factors. And the ability of the data clearinghouse to take time of use emissions factors can help us to validate and to track towards true zero and not just net zero. And you can do all sorts of other things. You can use the baseline for creating certificates in the energy savings schemes, and that creates an additional revenue stream for you. This journey towards true zero emissions is a journey that we're all on. It's possible in all buildings, big, small, residential, business, and the data clearinghouse is an ideal platform to track your journey towards true zero emissions. The New South Wales Digital Infrastructure for Energy Flexibility Project is led by CSIRO and proudly funded by the New South Wales Government. Our industry partners can help building owners to access the benefits of the project and also to connect to the data clearinghouse. To find out more, visit research.csiro.au/DCH.